today we'll be discussing about SQL translator while we are migrating anywhere data warehouse to the Google BigQuery. So for this, Google BigQuery has provided with a solution of SQL translation. So for this, we need to first create a SQL translator job in Google BigQuery. So once we are on SQL translation job, click on SQL translation. Give a name for the job. In my case, I am giving any random name. After that, you need to select the translation mode. In my case, it's Teradata SQL. And after that, you need to give the source detail where you have placed the source file for the SQL queries. In my case, it is Teradata queries. And then click on continue. And after that, you need to specify the destination path where you will place the translated query. I have taken it as translation underscore output. And after that, just create the job. Once the job is being created, Google BigQuery itself will take care of triggering that job. And once the job is being created, it will start to run automatically. So as we can see, job is being created and it is in running status now. We will check the job once it is being completed. As we can see now, the job is being completed and you can check the details in show details section. So once the job is being completed, you can see there were a total of 6 queries and 6 are being succeeded and there is 0 failure. Okay, so now let us go to the folder where we have kept our source queries. So Teradata queries, we have kept the source query. You can see we are having 4 folders over here and 4 files over here in which queries are being placed. So all the 4 file, the SQL translator will create 2 files. One will be the translated query one and the other will be the error file, error.csv. So if any error is being generated in the job, it will be present in this folder. So now let us check the files, whether the translation is being taken care by Google BigQuery SQL translator or not. So this is the first file and it is being translated and we do not see any error message in this file. So we can say this is being successfully translated, but there are some of the files in which the translation cannot be taken care by the SQL translator. So we need to take care of those translator manually, or we can say we need to do manual intervention for that. So for that thing, as you can see over here, we are having TD month end. So this TD month end is being supported by Teradata, but this TD month end query is not being supported by the Google BigQuery. Okay, so for this thing, we need to go for manual intervention. For this, we are using Jinja template. Okay, so I have created a Jinja template for this thing, month end Jinja.to. So TD month end will be replaced by the argument which is present in this particular file. So TD month end will be replaced by this particular date sub to the interval day one. Okay, for this I have written a Python function. That Python function will be responsible to replace this thing. Okay, so over here in this Python function, we are using regular expression. This regular expression, wherever it will find TD month end, it will replace that thing. If this regex is being matched, it will replace that thing with this particular Jinja template. Okay, so let us run this query. And the thing which we need to remember is this Jinja template is being only supported by Python 3. So you should have Python 3. So now let us open this file. This file will be generated once this job, this Python script is completed. So as you can see over here, that TD month end is being replaced by this particular argument which we have passed over here in this file. So date sub till the interval day one. So this is how we can take care of manual intervention using Jinja template, and the rest which is being taken care by the SQL translator itself. Now as we are already having all the SQL translated query, we'll try to run the translated query in the BigQuery whether it is being translated correctly or not. So for that we need to go to SQL workspace. So once we are inside the workspace, we need to paste the queries which is being converted and we'll run it. So we can see the result over here, like the query which we have, which is being converted, it is giving us the correct result. Now let us check once with the custom translated query, the one which we have translated using Jinja script, whether it is working fine or not. So now let's run this. So over here we can see we got the records. That means this SQL query is also been converted correctly as per the requirement. Thank you.